41 seconds to play. 79-70 is the score. Canada in front. Kavanagh on the line with a chance to narrow that margin for the U.S. And he misses. Cody Sims rebounds.
Steve, the fans are in this ballgame. They're behind that backboard, and they're showing jackets waving, flags waving, hands waving, trying to distract Kavanagh. I'll tell you, Jack Donahue would like nothing better than to win a medal right here in Canada. They've been working towards this for 10, 12 years, and they have an opportunity here to knock off the United States of America in a basketball competition of world caliber. What a great night for Canadian basketball, Steve.
Our statistician, Dan Melamed, has just handed me this. Eli Pasquale has 12 points on the game, 10 of those coming in the second half. So what a second half Eli Pasquale has had. And what a game John Hatch has had.
John Hatch has filled in admirably at that forward slot, and he has started many of the games for Canada in the tournament. And he just made a great play here by keeping his composure and his balance as he was pressured by the American player. He stays low in a squat, maintains his balance, and forces the foul. Of course, lost his balance but was knocked down in what was clearly a foul. So Hatch will be on the foul line here for a couple foul shots.
Big foul shots they are. Makes the first one. 80-71. Canada's margin is 9. Minute 21 seconds remaining to play. Second shot for Hatch.
The bench has performed admirably, Steve. Three Canadian starters have been out with fouls, and that great depth that Jack's developed over the course of this summer is paying off right now.
Seventh point of the ball game for Hatch, and it was a big point. Canada's margin is now 10, 81-71. 1:11 remaining to play. Turner with a shot from the corner. He hits. 81-73. 1:05 to play. Bounce pass into Pasquale. The U.S. has got great pressure on now, and it's too much pressure because Jay Humphrey's just too aggressive on that play, and he's called on the foul.
Of course, what the Americans want to try to do here now is stop the clock. There's 1:01 left, and the only way they can possibly win the game is in hopes that Canada elects to shoot the foul shots and misses them, and therefore they get a possession without Canada having scored. So they've got to be physical. We're going to see some fouls down the stretch of this ball game here. Now Jack's communicating with Triano. He's probably telling him, stay out of foul trouble. On the defensive end of the court now, make the U.S. spend time with the basketball, gobble the time on the clock, that's to Canada's advantage, and definitely don't foul and stop the clock.
82-73, 58 seconds remaining to play. Jay Triano going after that ball as if his life depended upon it. And the referee awards possession of the ball to the U.S. team over by the Canadian bench. Turner fires it into Durant. Back to Turner. Turner with a shot from long range. He hits. 82-75. 48 seconds remaining to play. Tony Sims racing after the ball. Keeps it inbounds for Canada. He only has 10 seconds to get it out of there. Jay Triano now. Triano up to Pasquale. Pasquale drive. It's good! 84-75. 32 seconds to play. Canada that close to a berth in the gold medal game against Yugoslavia. The clock is still running. Down to 24 seconds. And I believe we've got a jump ball.
Listen to the crowd, Steve. They know we're going for gold. It's all over. If Red Auerbach from the Boston Celtics, the legendary coach, were here, that cigar would be lit.
At this particular point, a standing ovation.
And
Jack Donahue has just called a timeout, and even that gets a standing ovation.
The crowd love it, the people love it, and in that crowd tonight, Premier Peter Lougheed of Alberta, Mr. Nebbiolo, the president of FISHU, the international body that stages these games, Ed Zemro, the president of the World University Games, just a tremendous crowd, everybody that's been anticipating Canada's basketball team to do well in these games turned out tonight to support him. And nobody can be more pleased than Ed Zemro, the president of the World University Games here in Edmonton of Universiade 83 Corporation. And the man, really, who most people on the local scene realize, Steve, he germinated the seed.
The countdown has begun. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And has earned a spot in the Yugoslavia. What a tremendous victory for this Canadian team who was so far down after losing to Yugoslavia.
Down, but not for long, Steve. They bounced back, this group of kids. They are together, and I'll tell you, are they happy. I can't believe Jack Donahue walking over casually to Norm Stewart like it's supposed to happen. But I know Jack believes it is supposed to happen. He thinks he's got this program now sitting on top of the world.
Start the count now. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. The game is over. Canada has won the gold. The men's basketball title in Universiade 83 goes to a young, valiant Canadian side. They defeat one of the world powers in basketball, Yugoslavia 83-68.
Just fantastic. Look at this camaraderie, Steve. It's the camaraderie that Jack believes gave them the edge in the tournament. They're a close-knit group of kids.
Jack Donahue being mobbed by his team, Greg Belcher. Tears, I'm sure, coming from his eyes. Doc Ryan is in there.
Steve, it's just unbelievable.
Look at this. Oh, boy, I tell you. Kelly Dukeshire, Danny Maher. Oh, what a moment.
Just unbelievable. What a group of kids. There's Carl Tillman, the Mike Mosier winner this year in university basketball. There goes Eli Pasquale up. They're going to cut down the nets.
One of the great traditions for winning teams in basketball is to be able to cut down that net. Eli Pasquale first up. Now Jay Triano will cut a few strings. Oh, boy, what a magic moment for Canadian basketball. Look at that.
Just fantastic. Here goes Tillman. He wants up there. No way he's waiting until all those cords are cut. He wants a piece of the action. This is just fantastic.
The crowd. Who goes up next? Everybody's going to get a turn.
The crowd.
Oh, they're going to try and get Big Bill Weddington up. He doesn't need any help. He just sticks his hand up and pulls himself up.
Well, I'll tell you, the crowd is just going nuts here, having the time of their life. They're stomping. They're clapping. They are into it.
Hey, I want my two strands. Canadian flags in the stands, and now the Canadian team has got a flag. Danny Maher gets to cut a couple. My boy, if anybody deserves to, he does.
They'll have trouble getting Maher down from there, Steve. He'll stay up there all night and keep cutting. There's the man of the hour, Jack Donahue.
And now Howard Kelsey, who has 8 years with this Canadian team. This is the moment that Howard, I'm sure, has lived through. All the sweat, the tears, the tremendous hard work. Yes, sir, that says it all. A big smile for this Canadian men's basketball team.
Here goes Kaz, a surprise starter in many ways. Wilcher and Weddington carry the team this far.
Okay, they want Jack Donahue to cut the last strand. What a great gesture by this Canadian team. They want the coach.
This is just fabulous, Steve. It's one of the most emotional moments, not only for Jack, but everybody in this building. What a
time. Jack Donahue, the last snip brings the net down, and that symbolizes so much, I'm sure, in the mind of Jack Donahue. All those years, oftentimes frustrating. And now the Canadian team starts to run around the floor. The traditional laugh of victory with the Canadian flag held high.
That is just phenomenal. Look at that flag flowing. Tillman and Kazanowski taking it around the court. The pride, the national pride, the patriotism. I'll tell you, it's going to be a phenomenal year of preparation for the Olympic Games.